Satanism can briefly be defined as the worship of Satan and taking him as a god. This perverse movement that rejects God, all religions and religious values, and makes it a rule to practice things regarded by religion as sinful, accepts Satan, the representative of evil, as a lord and guide. Satanists have existed and practiced their deceitful activities in every period of history and in every culture, from ancient Egypt to ancient Greece, and from the Middle Ages to the present day. Between the 14th and 16th century, sorcerers and those who had turned their backs on religion both worshipped Satan. After the 1880s, in France, England, Germany, as well as in other countries of Europe and in America, Satanism became organized and spread among those looking for alternative religions and beliefs. The worship of Satan has continued to exist since the 19th century, first as traditional Satanism, and later in smaller perverse sects that split off from it. The savage rites performed by sorcerers and godless individuals, the sacrifice of children and adults to Satan, the celebration of the Black Mass, and other ceremonies of traditional Satanism have been passed down secretly from generation to generation. The most important symbol of traditional Satanism was the ancient Roman god, Baphomet. In time, Baphomet became the symbol of those who worship Satan. Historians tracing the provenance of this goat-headed figure have discovered some important clues about Satanist activities. The second most important Satanist symbol is the pentagram, a five-pointed star inscribed within a circle. It is interesting that there were two other secret organizations besides the Satanists that adopted Baphomet and the pentagram as symbols. The first of these organizations was the Templar Knights of Jerusalem, an order that was accused by the Catholic Church of worshipping Satan and disbanded in 1311. The other organization is the Masons, who have aroused curiosity for years with their secrecy and strange rites. Many historians who have investigated the matter believe that there is a relationship between the Templar Knights of Jerusalem and the Masons. In their opinion, these two groups were a continuation of one another. After the Templar Knights of Jerusalem were banned by the Church, the organization continued its existence in secrecy and finally turned into Masonry. What is certain about Freemasonry is that it is a secretive and very hierarchical organization with members all over the world. Accounts given by authors such as Leo Taxil, who were once Masons but left the organization, say that Masons treat Baphomet with great reverence and conduct ceremonies that resemble rituals of satanic worship. Another fact that arouses suspicion is that many Satanists over time have become members of the Masonic organization. Today, Satanism has left its secret rituals and lodges and flowed into the streets. Satanists work concertedly in every country, disseminating their intense propaganda in books, periodicals, and especially on the internet in their attempts to gain members. No matter in what country they may be, Satanists display a common image. Their style of dress, ways of worship, the similarity of the suicide notes they leave behind, and other such details show that Satanism is not an ordinary movement full of good-for-nothings, but an organization based deliberately on ideological foundations. Although the existence of Satan worshippers has been known for years, no one ever came forward to admit openly that they were Satanists. Satanism first became an open and organized movement in the 1960s in the US. On April 30, 1966, the Church of Satan was formed in California. The founder of this strange church was a Satanist by the name of Anton Zandor Lavey, who proclaimed himself high priest. Known as the Black Pope, Lavey wrote books in which he formulated his views on the Church of Satan. The titles of the books are frightening: The Satanic Bible, The Satanic Rituals, The Satanic Witch, The Devil's Notebook, and Satan Speaks. Lavey died in 1997. It is estimated that the Church of Satan has about 10,000 members in North America, and despite many lawsuits, its activities and ceremonies continue. A noticeable characteristic of present-day Satanists is that they are all atheists. At the same time, they are materialists. That is, they believe only in the existence of matter. They deny the existence of God and of all metaphysical beings. Satanists do not, therefore, believe in Satan as a real being. Despite being called Satan worshippers, they do not accept the existence of Satan. For Satan,